Hi, everyone, and welcome.
Hi, Miss Tina.
Hi, Miss Tina.
So today what we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit about the way things are going and the way things might be in our families, because we're getting ready for something really special. What are we getting ready for?
The birth of Jesus.
The birth of Jesus, and we call that Christmas, right?
Or Advent.
Advent's a season that helps us prepare to get ready. So to get ready in Advent, we have to do some things. If I would sing a lyric to a song and start it, see if you can, if you know what song it goes to. It's the one that goes, we have to make room in our heart. We have to make room. Does anybody know that song? That Christmas carol, Miss Jen, do you know it? We have to make room. You know the one that goes, heaven and nature, we have to make room. Anyone know that song?
Nature sing, and heaven and nature sing. My brother's been playing the Spider-Man version. So what is it? Go ahead and sing the Spider-Man version.
Oh, is the Spider-Man version?
No.
So anyway, the song.
Going to the world? No.
Yeah.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive
her King.
Let every heart
prepare him room.
What does that mean? Let every heart prepare him room.
Hey,
That's why we have like Advent, to open our hearts so we can get ready for the birth of Jesus.
So we prepare our hearts, we get ready, kind of like in Bethlehem, they had to get ready for Jesus to be born, and they had to find a place to stay. In fact, they had to find a stable, and there's a manger in the stable, and we make room for Jesus to be born. So when we look at our lives and we look at making room in our hearts, what do you think that means, to make room in our hearts? What do we have to do? Go ahead, just talk.
To care for Jesus.
To care for Jesus and
to come for peace to the world.
Okay, yeah, we care for Jesus and we want to allow peace to enter the world. But how do we make that peace happen? Because when we prepare a room, what happens? What do we have to do? Any ideas?
We become kind and loving and think more about Jesus instead of ourselves.
Absolutely. So that's what we're going to talk about now. We got to be kind of look at our lives and say, how have things been going? So how, you know, you've been home and you've not always been with your friends and you're not getting away from one another a lot of times. What's happening at home, do you think?
People are going crazy.
Yeah, I would say that. So that's like an expression. If you had to think about something right now, something about the way you've been over the last few days, have you been exactly on, or have you had any moments when you're slightly off?
Yeah, I've had a few moments where I'm off.
You had a few moments when you were off? I know I had one yesterday. Anybody else have any moments when they're off? What Absolutely. Does it look like when you're off?
You're not listening to God and Jesus?
Yeah, we're not listening to God and Jesus. What about listening to our adults and our parents? AJ?
Yeah, I was going to say, sometimes you're just like so mad you don't care about anything and just get really mad and don't talk to anyone about anything.
Yeah. Or sometimes you ever say things that in response to somebody, but it has nothing to do with them, and you sort of respond in a irritated negative way.
Yeah,
that happens to me. I just did that earlier. So there's an expression called poke the bear. What do you think poke the bear means?
It means like don't annoy someone, because like say there was a bear and I had a stick, if I was poking the bear with a stick, the bear would remain calm. But then when I started poking him with a stick, he'd get like mad and try to attack me.
Yeah. So if a bear were a brother or sister or a parent or an aunt or an uncle, what would it mean to poke the bear?
Maybe just like arguing or taking something, or I don't know.
Yeah, no, I think you're on the right track.
Yeah.
Abby, you have any ideas?
That you're being mean to the bear, so you're just like boiling. So poking means the same thing as boiling. So,
bullying, yes.
Boiling. That is it. And you're just being mean to the other person, and you don't follow the directions. So you're like poking the bear, and that means the same thing as boiling.
So if you were gonna poke the bear named your mom, how might you poke her?
I don't know.
You don't know? Can you think of anything that ever has happened when you kind of poked her?
I might like yell or like push or hit her, do something mean.
Do something mean, yeah. Have you ever had trouble once you started to poke the bear stopping?
Yeah.
And just keep going and going and escalating it?
Yeah, a little.
What's an example of what might happen when we're poking the bear and we can't stop ourselves? Can you think of a good example that might have happened with your brothers or your aunt or your cousin?
You might insult your brother, and then he says like something back that annoys you, and then you keep on like going and throwing insults at each other and then start fighting.
Yeah, that's very well stated. Very well stated, yes. And then it sort of just escalates, and sometimes you can't even remember the very thing that started the poking of the bear. Right? Josie's not around. Is she, Miss Jen?
No, she is not.
So what might
be, upstairs.
That's okay. Well, I was just gonna, what might be an example of poking the bear in your house?
In my house?
Yeah, because you have little ones.
Oh, you know, when they throw all the books on the floor, or they don't listen. Yeah, when they dump their plate of food on the ground, or rip a book. Oh, ripping books.
Yeah. So do you think that we sometimes poke the bear just because we're frustrated with other things, frustrated mm-hmm. about something else?
Yeah.
So in the season of Advent, if every time we poke the bear means that we put a little bit of garbage in our heart, maybe you can pull out that heart you have over there with you and show what our hearts can kind of look like on the inside. See, that's our normal one on the outside, but when we open it up, we have all kinds of stuff in there.
Yeah, all kinds of trash and wrappers and all kinds of things.
And those are the things that sort of get in the way of us shining our light and being the best us we can be. Do you think it sort of like crowds our heart out?
Yeah. Is there much room in here for things? For the things we love?
No.
No.
No. What's in that heart then? A bunch of what?
Garbage.
Wait. And so remember how we started joy to the world, our Savior's come. We have to make room in there. How do we make room and get that garbage out so that we can prepare a bed for Jesus, a new place for Jesus to be born in us and to be shining through us again? What do you think we might do?
So we just be calm and be steady, and we don't yell and try to be calm and don't yell. And
I really like that word that you use called steady, to be calm and steady. So in order for us to be calm and steady, what do we have to do with that garbage that's in that heart? I think you were going to say something, AJ.
We have to confess our sins and stop doing the garbage.
When we confess our sins, we go and celebrate a sacrament, right? Do you remember what that sacrament's called?
Confession?
Yeah, it's called confession or reconciliation, which means we join something that's broken and we put it back together. So we take the garbage out. But there's a step that might have to happen beforehand. You have to kind of think about what might be the garbage. So we call that an examination of conscience. We kind of look at what we've said, what we've done. We say words like what we failed to do, even if we know what the right thing to do is, but we turned our back and didn't do it anyway. So for example, if you were in your house and you saw a pile of, books on the floor, what would be the right thing to do, AJ?
Clean up the toys and not ask for anything in return.
Yeah, but is it easy to do it if you didn't make the mess?
No.
No, it isn't. It's hard to clean up somebody else's mess. So we might pretend we don't see it. We might walk away and because it wasn't our mess. So Advent challenges us to not walk away, to kind of clean up the messes and open up our heart to make room for Jesus. One of the ways we do that is we do things for others. We also, as we celebrate the sacrament of reconciliation, we also have to kind of experience it in our family. What might be something we do in our family to experience reconciliation? You don't necessarily, because Abby is just preparing to go to confession for the first time in the next months ahead, and you're a seasoned person, AJ. What do we do also, though, to help us seek that forgiveness, not just from God, but from one another? What are some things we might do?
We might say sorry to help the people that we hurt.
Yeah, what are words that we might say?
I'm sorry, or I love you, or I don't know.
No, that's exactly it. I'm sorry. But you know what's sorry, which one doesn't work? When someone says, tell them you're sorry, and you go, sorry. Does that sound authentic and real?
No.
No, how does it become real then?
You have to say it in a nice soft voice and say it like, I'm sorry, whatever the name comes after.
Yeah, that's so right. And what has to happen in your heart, Abby, when you say that I'm sorry?
That you have to mean it,
and you have to mean it,
and you have to take care of it.
You're right. You have to take care of what you, the mess you made, even if it's just making room in your heart. So
garbage.
Yeah, get rid of the garbage. So what's the difference between saying you're sorry and being forgiven? Anybody know what saying sorry and being forgiven means, or forgiving somebody else?
To forgive, is what the person you're saying sorry to says? Or?
Yeah, no, you're on the right path. Tell me more about that. Because someone can, if I did something wrong and I said I'm sorry, what part has to happen with you, though?
You have to truly forgive. You can't just say it out of anger or
you say okay, but you don't change your heart, right? You got to change your heart. So both people, both things have to work together. But what do we know about God and forgiveness?
God is very forgiving.
So when we ask forgiveness, what happens with God?
He forgives us.
Too.
What did you say? Say that to me again.
And Jesus too.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So when I ask God for forgiveness, am I assured that I have that forgiveness?
Yeah.
Even if the person I offended isn't quite there yet, ready to forgive me, if I've truly come to God and asked for forgiveness, it's mine. But we have to give the other person whom we may have harmed some time. So what are things that we can kind of do to make get rid of that garbage right now? We said celebrate the sacrament. What else?
Like what we were saying earlier, if like someone has a mess, like you could clean it up for them or do like kind deeds and good deeds to the people that you were mean to and to people just in general.
So in our houses, what would be a good deed there? Because that's where we're at pretty much all the time these days. What's a good house deed?
We have to, if it's even not our mess or we didn't even do anything, we still have to clean up. We still have to care for it. Because what happens if your mom accidentally forgot to clean up their mess or their dad and they're at their work or they're at somewhere? So it's good to, when you see it, you don't just run away. You still have to do it because that's such a good deed to try and do what you have to do and follow your heart and take all the garbage.
Yeah. So I would say an example of garbage might be if we talked back to one of our parents. Now, I know that doesn't happen in any of your homes, but how do we take that back if that happened to be something we've been doing lately? We've been wearing our sassy frass pants. What are we, sassy pants. What do we do to take that back?
Say sorry and like not do it and maybe like offer to do something kind to them.
Yeah, what would be a kind thing that you would do to somebody you've shown sassy frass pants to?
Maybe write them something that says, like, I'm sorry, especially if it's your parents.
Oh, my. That is a really awesome answer. Yeah. You might write them a note.
On there, and the dad didn't go to the soccer game for his daughter, and he doesn't have any paper, so he just writes on toilet paper and he just says, I'm so, and then it says sorry at the end.
That's a beautiful commercial, isn't it? So sometimes writing a note, that was a really great answer. Sometimes using words, telling them that we're sorry, sometimes doing something kind for them. But the best thing we do after that is to try not to do it again. And that's the hard part, because sometimes we just want to poke that bear. So we have poke. So we have to work at saying we're sorry, but also trying not to ever do it again. So say that we used a word that wasn't becoming of us. Say we called our brother or sister, or maybe even our mom or dad, a word we shouldn't have, or we used God's name in a way that didn't express how great and wonderful and how holy God is. What do we need to do about that?
We could, like, every time we said, like, we use God's name in vain, we could, like, say in Our Father or something, or Hail Mary.
Yeah, we could do that. And a prayer. We could, every time we do it, we can snap ourselves and then try to say, God, you are holy. And, you know, kind of instead of saying, you know, expressing, oh my goodness, oh my God, about a piece of chocolate cake, we say, God, you are holy. You are most high. We kind of try to remind ourselves who God is, using God's name only to express good things, but not using it in a way that condemns somebody else or hurts somebody else or makes it ordinary. So that's one of the things we have to look at. We have to also look at how much are we in our friendship with Jesus. During the pandemic, it's hard to be a church. It's hard to do things. How are we praying? Are we praying? Are we talking to God about things? If we say that we're too busy but have time to be on the internet and time to play our games, and we don't have time to say a prayer to God, we need to kind of examine that and say, how do I change this? Because all it takes is, you know, God just wants a piece of us. So 5 minutes, 5 minutes a day. Any other ways you think we can might take out that trash out of our heart and make room for Jesus this Christmas? You've covered a lot. Any other thoughts before we go? Miss Jackie, Dana, who was going to talk? Who was that?
Me. Sometimes, like, if it's your parents or brothers, just giving them a hug is just a lot of times.
Just a high five. Say, that was a really good dinner, Mom. High five. Dad, thank you for taking me somewhere. Don't leave me hanging. Give me that high five. Abby, you have a thought? Because you're making cool things over there.
X.
I was going to say, is that hugs and kisses? X and O?
Yes.
That's nice, Abby.
Yeah. Well, any questions for me about making room for baby Jesus in the inn, bringing him home? Any questions you might have this Advent before we say goodbye?
No.
No. I don't have any. Abby?
No.
No. Miss Dana?
I don't think so.
Miss Jen?
That was great. How can we go to confession during this time and maybe go to Mass together or see Mass?
That is a good question. Well, we are going to put in the notes afterwards, there'll be some information about some times that we can go to reconciliation, and we're following the COVID protocols. We could also have a night in our family where we just spend time saying we're sorry. And there's some information about how to do that. And we also can always tune into some things related to Mass virtually if we're unable to be in person. Mass is being offered every week and then it's posted on our parish webpage or our parish YouTube page. And there's also ones from all across the world. It's kind of fun to celebrate Mass when you in another place that you always wanted to go, like Notre Dame or the Vatican. You can go to different Masses because they're offered all the time. And when we do that, we remind ourselves who we are as a family of God, as Catholics. And then we long for the day when we can be together in the churches. Some of us are able to come now in churches, but some of us just might not be the right time. The doors are open though, and we have Masses going on every day and every week. That was a great question. So if that's all, why don't we pray together? Let's make this, actually, AJ, lead us in the sign of the cross for me.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen.
Good and gracious God, we anxiously say, come, Lord Jesus. We remember your first coming. We look forward to your coming again to bring the kingdom of God. But most importantly, Lord, we are in the now. We ask you to come each and every day into our hearts. Help us to make room for you. Remind us and nudge us how to get the garbage out and to be more like you every day. To help us not poke bears, but rather pet the bear and make the bear comfortable and happy. Lord God, we ask you to bless each of us with the graces we need in our families and in our personal lives. We ask, Lord, that you accompany those who may be passing this day, and we join together praying the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy
Spirit. Amen.
We want to thank you for being with us, Abby. I am so grateful you joined us today. So thank you, Miss Dana and Abby. And AJ, thank you for being with your, I see your hand, I'll ask you a question. Thank you for helping me out as usual and sitting there with your Aunt Jen. You were going to say something, AJ.
And like a lot of times now that you can't go to Mass, like a lot of people I know don't have designated like praying or like praying spaces in their house, but like now you really should make one, like even if it's just like a small stuff where you put all like your like a sign of the cross in your room to like pray at. It's like super important now because at the church, like or we can't go to the church as often, and a lot of people just can't go at all.
You're making my heart swell. You are so right. That is such a wise statement. And on that note, amen. Thanks for tuning in. Look forward to seeing you to the next time, and help us empty out that box and make room in our hearts. Bye.
Bye.